Scott Cawthon just released the first official teaser trailer for Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Before digging into the trailer itself too much, it is vital to include information provided on Five Nights at Freddy's 3 Steam Greenlight page, which reads, 30 years after Freddy Fazbear's Pizza closed its doors, the events that took place there have become nothing more than a rumor and a childhood memory. But the owners of Fazbear's Fright, the horror attraction, are determined to revive the legend and make the experience as authentic as possible for patrons, going to great lengths to find anything that might have survived decades of neglect and ruin. At first, there were only empty shells, a hand, a hook, an old paper plate doll, but then a remarkable discovery was made. The attraction now has one animatronic. And not even 24 hours after the game came out on Steam Greenlight, Scott posted this announcement on its Steam page, where he debunks the rumor that the game will be released on February 5th. He states that he still has a lot of work to do, and that he's working hard on making a great game for us to play, and to please be patient. I say, take your time and do it right, Scott. The last thing anyone would want is that game that's so rushed that it fails to deliver the Five Nights experience that we all know and love so much. Alright now, moving on with the theories. So this game happens after the first game in chronological order. The game now features only one animatronic, which most are already referring to as Golden Bonnie. But who or what is Golden Bonnie exactly? Let's analyze the text. He will come back. He always does. We have a place for him. He is most likely referring to the children's killer, aka the purple guy. This is reinforced by Scott's site, scottgames.com, where, simultaneous with the release of the trailer, the site featured the text, "He always does," like in the trailer, but it is in purple text, indicating that he is in reference to the purple guy. Checking today, the day after the trailer was released, that image is gone and replaced with the previous one. Now then, what does "we have a place for him" mean? Well, right after that text shows, Golden Bonnie is seen on the floor jittering violently. It is likely that the souls of the dead kids are trying to imprison the soul of their murderer, but everything has been left in pieces. But now, this figure off to the side, which is now easily identifiable as Golden Bonnie, is the remarkable discovery that was made, and so the souls of the kids force the soul of their killer into the Golden Bonnie animatronic. Also, when you save the image on Scott's site, it saves with the file name, "What Can We Use?" Possibly being from the perspective of the souls of the kids wondering, what can we use to trap the purple guy's soul in? The violent jittering is probably the result of the killer being put into the new animatronic, as he is seen later in the trailer being able to move quite smoothly. And about that, he doesn't jump at you or get right in your face right away. He just seems to observe you for a moment. That's disconcerting. Scott Cawthon is a master at dropping hints and withholding information to make you think you can figure it out, and then show you something unexpected, like Golden Bonnie in the trailer. Honestly, I highly doubt Scott has given the key to figuring out everything yet, and will save all of the big reveals for the actual third game when it's finally released. Until then, he'll continue to build up more anticipation than his fanbase can bear. Haha, get it? Bear? Anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Please check out my channel for some of my Five Nights gameplay videos. If you like what you see, please leave a like and a subscribe so you won't miss out on any future awesomeness. Have a great day, everyone. If I can't close the door, I know that means one of them's in here. Okay. Quiet for a little bit. Oh!